So this match, I'm going to be playing some Genji. I'm not the strongest Genji player, well, and Overwatch or Heroes of the Storm. However, I'm trying to get him to level 5. He's almost there. He's like halfway through level 4. So we'll see how it goes. Something I always am cautious of when I'm playing Genji is I try not to make those big plays. So when I'm playing Genji that I've played so far, I really haven't looked at too many builds for this, either from either Immune Ferrets or Palutena. Those are people that I watch when I play. So I usually go with the Swift Strike grants move speed because I feel that has a lot of chase potential slash escape potential if needed. I'm not sure how good Genji is going to be on Battlefield of Eternity because he doesn't do a lot of damage. He's really good at getting those last kills, those like last hits, and just harassing with, especially with their shurikens. So if you look, his Q ability is a shuriken, and it's has a 3 charges, and it's all on the same cooldown. So and our W is deflect, so what happens is he deflects. Oh, that's really not good. Oh, that's really not good. He deflects damage to the target. The W is a quick line of attack like that, so he can get escape. And the D is his jump, so he can actually jump over terrain, which is really nice. So we need to, I mean, I hope we're getting top value. In fact, I'm gonna hurt. I wish that they really don't have. I mean, the Falstad and Zul'jin are pretty quick attackers, but that's where the deflect really comes into play, like the Tracer or a Tychus is a really good character to go up against when he's using deflect. So that Swift Strike that I just did, if I would have landed the killing blow on that, hopefully the Falstad that died. My Swift Strike would have had a cooldown reduction, so I could have used it again right away. And so that's when you can do some like fun dive things over the wall and kill somebody over the enemy's wall, but then sweep back and. Let me see if Matt, he's so strong on this map because his he does the damage over time, which impacts percentage based. It's percentage based damage to the immortal. So we're just gonna go all in here. We're probably gonna die. We're gonna die. We did get one kill. Oh, actually. Oh, wait, no, they got us. Never mind. I like going Shuriken Master on here. I think some people said that this was. This one's good. This one's good. It's the other one where. When you have to hit all the targets at once with one shuriken, because it is like that cone shape, but if you get all three in one, it deals additional damage, which isn't actually as hard as you think, especially it helps when clearing out immortals and, or other bigger targets. Now this is getting very little Arbalas helping destroy this. Get to my shuriken stacks here, because when I get, I think it's 35, it will increase the damage, so it could just help with that poking potential. Oh, good job. Oh, wait, that's not our Nazebo. Oh, so good job. There, Nazebo. Yep. Follow, watch out. You're gonna die. So Genji should not be clearing lanes. Oh no. So that's where that Swift Strike comes into play. Pretty easy. You can get out of barriers like the zombie wall and stuff like that, which is nice. I like going Reflect, so I do the Reflect cooldown. And that's based on how much damage you get. While deflect is happening. And that counts for minions too. Oh, we need to defend, apparently. Okay. That's good. Okay. We are going to take a little bit of a break, go get some health, some mana, and then we'll be back. We're getting a good push out of that. This one, did we get? Oh, Falstad got killed, I think, by our immortal, which is good. So if we can get another pick off, we should be golden. We do have a Tracer and myself who should be able to defend. Oh, that's good. Oh, there, look. Okay, so let's. That Swift Strike, I'm not sure if you saw it, that's when it, refreshed itself, so I went back in to try to get another kill on the, I always forget his name. And I play Diablo 3 a lot. Oh, so they're gonna come back in now. There we go, get out of there. Ooh, there's some good roots. Let's use some poke. Ooh, that was close. Oh, freaking spiders. Poke. Dash. Oh, we got a screen freeze. What's going on? Oh, that's terrifying, actually. Okay. See that little damage on the auto on his auto attack with that deflect. Oh, he's that. Oh. It's almost Bonds. Oh, we should actually go defend. Because we're not going to be able to. So I think people go both ways with the heroics. I am not good at Dragon Blade at all. I've tried it before and I'm not great at it. So I go X-Strike. So it it's kinda cool because they completed the first part of my quest. It what? I need to stop walking into things like that. It allows me to do things like this. And get a 3-person kill. Actually, I get a quad kill. So, that's pretty sweet. Yeah, so that's what X-Strike is really good for, is when they're pumped up like that. You can lay it down on them, and it's awesome. That was actually pretty sweet. That was probably one of my best Genji plays. So. Kinda sad I'm not getting more love from my team for. That's actually good as Sylvanas to push up. Oh, we should go up here though. Go help against those old gen. Let's see, I can go in and I can go out, which is a nice little thing because you can secure those behind the tower kills without getting yourself in a position of getting severely attacked. Good silence. Do this again. That did not work. Deflect the damage. The deflect does work on buildings as well, so if you do find yourself kind of stuck, you can go back. So this is the one that I was talking about with the increased shuriken on the single target damage. Yeah, we should probably get that. Let's go up there. Maybe we can get a kill on the false stab as well. Because we don't need to push that bad. I mean, it's just, it is what it is at this point. Okay, so that was good. We were able to use that deflect to, get them, even though that we couldn't. I don't know if I should have auto attacked them, to be honest. But if you look, like, our hero damage, it's not the highest, but we have 9 kills so far in the game. Granted, that next strike helped a lot. We can kill him pretty easily with the, well, the Vala help. So with him dead, it actually makes things a lot easier on the immortal. Because he's not doing that percentage based damage. Maybe this X-Strike here, do some deflect, oh, and I got Enderling Blasted, which sucked. That was good, the Immortal. So, yeah, so if you look, actually, I'm actually doing pretty good on hero damage in this game, at the second highest in the game. We do need to regroup. We need to, we are not getting any immortal damage. The Tracer's right. If we did get one, because we do have the Sylvanas, we could push so hard. Falstad? I really like Falstad. I used to play him. I don't play him very much anymore. I'm not really sure why. I think because we've got heroes that I enjoy just as much, but I maybe enjoy playing a little bit more. Like, I love playing Tracer. I love. Oh, I'm dead. I was thinking I could go in there and swoop and kill that Zul'jin and get out in time, but obviously I could not. I love, like I was saying, I love Tracer, love Chromie. Actually, just really enjoying Genji a lot. He has that really all-in play style, which I'm starting to enjoy a lot more. I'm really excited for Skull Rove or whatever, the new support coming in. I never played StarCraft. I was more of a Warcraft fan growing up, so I never really. Oh, I forgot that one. I never really knew the names for them. Like, that's like, if you look at the forums, they want more Heroes of StarCraft, and I just don't know any of them. So I get excited when I see StarCraft Heroes because it helps me learn a little bit more lore about them. Oh, that's another hero that I secretly like playing. I'm not very good with at all, but Probius, he's fun. But I'm not good with him at all. I want to get better with him. That was awesome. Let's go down here and get this. Actually, let's go get theirs. I like the Lost Vikings a lot too. Zul'jin's fun too, but I never really know the best times to like use as Dingo and all that jazz. That was stupid, all that, but whatever. I mean, it's probably honestly something I would have done if I was playing full stat, but it's not a smart move. Boop. Good job, Tracer. So, we're actually in a very good position because they only have their Nazebo up. We have Sylvanas pushing with the Shamans, which are by far the strongest mercenary camp in the game. This little guy here can continually spawn those little tiger wolf thingies, which is fantastic. And so they eat up a lot of ammo for the building, but they also do a lot of damage in that sense. So if you don't take care of that, they will push to their little heart's content. We want to go. Let's go try to kill Isabel. The ice blocked. So that's what Genji is all about. We need to go defend. It's securing those kills. That was a good one. I'm not sure what she's really doing with whatchamacallit. Mind control, which I don't mind. Mind control is an ult. I actually think it could be good to secure some kills. It's not great in a team fight, because a team fight you really do want that withering arrow where the whole team is silenced. Like, that's definitely much more team fight useful thing, but it's also kind of fun too. Oh my god, we got one, that's awesome. So we can push with our Sylvanas. Oh, I'm the only one alive with our Sylvanas. Sucks, we need to go defend. I thought that. Well, I guess we have Sylvanas. That's going to. Man, just look at that damage. It's insane. He's not even going to make it to the towers. He's going to make it to the towers. You know what? We've been hitting a lot of them grouped up, so we're going to do this. Sometimes I like to go the damage hits everybody. Though I wish that you were able to have a counter of how much damage you've locked already. That way you know how much damage, so you just have a better gauge of, because you have to have a block like 6800 damage or something like that, but you don't know what that is. So if there was an indicator be awesome. Let's do this. So that actually reduced my cooldown immensely. So I think it's one of those things. If I can get enough, hit enough of them, you can just continue to X strike. It does a lot of damage. What's nice now is when I do my Swift Strike, because I completed my challenge here, or my quest there, it allows, so when I do my Swift Strike, I get two additional charges of my shurikens, so like if I'm out of my shurikens, I can move forward. It won't go above 3 though, so there's no like real reason to do anything. I can understand wanting to do the shrink, right? I am kind of hurting them a lot, but we need to. That's what we need to do. Son of a gun. I think that might actually... Oh, we have stuff on it, so... I actually don't mind the impalers either. They're pretty good, too. Problem is, we're not getting these immortals. I'm not very instinctive. I've had 5 deaths. So Vanas is doing a pretty good job of staying alive. I'm doing a lot of damage. I didn't expect to do this much damage. I'm getting, I have 28 kill participation, so it's pretty good. So this is good. If they don't respond to this, they don't respond to this. This is good because then they'll push all the way in, and that's actually really good. So Vanas can help push them in, but we do need to defend. We do. Look at my siege damage. I don't do a lot. Okay, so we'll go up here. But we should be okay, because we do have our keep there, so it's not like they're going straight for our core. And what's also really nice is they can't make boss or anything during this period. It's pretty easy defense. I mean, it's not ideal, but we need to kill some of them. Honestly, if we kill them, we could easily push. Son of a gun, those roots. Roots are so good. All right, there we got Zoljin. Zoljin's got a lot of kills too, so this Falstad. I think I would say Zoljin has a lot of deaths, but he has just as many deaths as I do. Way more experience too. Oh, that's a good dodge. Falstad has a pretty cool addition to this Hinterland Blast. I think it's baseline at 10. I'm not sure if it's at level 20 as well, or at just level 20, where for every character he hits, it's a reduced time on his Hinterland Blast. That's kind of similar to the X-Strike. Darmouth Furion, he went Twilight Dream, right? Twilight Dream is so good. I think at level 20, did you do, Storm Shield's really good too, but I think the Twilight Nightmare, the new thing, is that, you can, blink in, because they're getting rid of Hold of the Storm, but yeah, now you can blink in and, cast Twilight Dream. Sylvan, I think she needs. I prefer that if they did not do the mind control away from us. Okay, we just need to go heal really fast. Oh, there's only the two of us alive. It's one of those situations. It's kind of a non-win kind of situation because if we don't defend these, they're going to take out our core really fast. But if we go there, if we're not by doing that, we're not defending our immortal. It's kind of a no-win situation. And I'm really not the best person to be clearing things. See that? Honestly, sometimes if you would just silence the one or two heroes, especially the supports. Wow, that has to go. He did better than I did. There's Zul'jin. He's also on the winning team. I should be on. I should get some upvotes somehow, though. There it is. Am I gonna get any of it? Yeah, I'll give it to Zul'jin. Boop. Come on. We would have won. He still wouldn't have leveled up. Stats-wise, I was behind Zul'jin heavily in that, but on my team, actually the rest of the game, I got came in second with that. Pretty good. Talents, Swift Strike, Movement Speed, Shuriken Quest, Cooldown, X-Strike, bonus damage, reflect damage, and the living weapon where reduce cooldown. So cool, thanks for stopping by. Hope you liked Genji. I'm going to get him to level 5 eventually. I probably won't do another video of that. But if you have a hero you want me to play, comments below. Like, subscribe, follow me on Twitter @GamerStream, and I will talk to you later. Bye.